Meg.
What are you two scheming about?
Well, we were just, discussing who has the better surprise planned for your wedding day.
Well, I've got a surprise for you both. There's not going to be a wedding unless I'm back at my fitting in 2 seconds with the new shoes mom and I bought yesterday.
Oh, yeah, I know exactly where they are. I'll get them.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you. I swear, the closer the wedding gets, the crazier I get.
Well, it's the lack of oxygen. You're too happy to breathe.
Yeah, I guess the air is pretty thin up here. Gosh, Casey, marrying Ben is like a dream come true. And it's going to be perfect this time with all my friends and my family and you as our best man.
Well, I still can't believe Ben is willing to trust me with the wedding rings.
Well, he trusts you with more than the rings. He knows that you were the first person I met here and that you saved my life. And I think of you as my guardian angel. It wouldn't be right if you weren't standing up there with us when we were married. We wouldn't have it any other way.
Neither would I, Meg. And I promise to be your guardian angel even after you and Ben are married. Okay?
Okay.
This is strange.
Hey, I was just stopping by and I saw, Ben take off for a jog.
You did? I don't believe it. I was in the kitchen. I did not even hear him.
Wait a minute. You spent the night here? You didn't even meet Ben yet?
No, if you told me this was happening to you, I would say you were making it up. Meg, I left for a fitting and I stayed behind to make breakfast for Ben. Do you think he'll be back soon?
I wouldn't count on that. Ben goes for these really long jogs, and if you wait around for him, you might miss your therapy session with Dr. Estrada. But lucky for you, I stopped by. I can give you a ride over there. Come on.
Doesn't anybody close the door behind them in this town?
Hey.
Gabby, hi. The fitting can't be over.
Oh, Meg forgot her shoes, and since you're supposed to be back at Cedar Oaks, and Meg is not going to be back in time to have breakfast with you and Ben, she asked me to drive you.
Look, I really appreciate all the help, but I really want to meet Ben.
When I get very far like this, might as well head back home now.
Bye. Bye, Meg. Be safe.
Thanks. Well, even though you guys are no longer roommates, it's nice to see that you've stayed close. It's nice.
Yeah. Well, I'll never stop caring about Meg, even after she's married to Ben. So what do you say? Ready to give Melinda a taste of her own medicine, huh?
Yeah, I'm ready to try.
Yeah, well, then she's as good as gotten. She's so blinded by dollar signs, she'll never see this coming. Not from you. Come on.